Hello everybody and welcome to my YouTube channel, Art Classes My Way. And today we're going to be trying something a little different. Let me know what you guys think about this. I've been thinking about all the different tools that are available out there for jewelry people and possibly doing reviews on the different tools. Like this guy, for instance. And especially with people like my mother, who will just go out, like, buy, you know, on a 360-acre farm, and we have a whole bunch of miniature horses, and she will buy a hose that is all curly, so that way when you're done with it, it just immediately curls back up into a small, compact little thing. Problem is, you can't leave the hose at the thing. You have to stand there at the watering trough and hold the hose, rather than just leaving it hang over to fill the water trough, and you go and do other stuff. So it's a completely gimmicky thing that doesn't really function. And I've been thinking about that with all the tools that are available for jewelry smithing. And let me know what you guys think. And I will see about possibly doing more. Now this guy, some of you may or may not know, and it looks terrifying. This is a spinner. And just full disclosure, I am not being paid by these guys to do anything. They did not send me this to review and whatnot. It is just something that I have that I haven't really played with too much yet, and my husband is going to help me demonstrate it in video for everybody. Now, I'm just going to show you how to get this guy started as far as opening it up and so on, because you can't open it this way, and it takes a little bit of finagling to figure out. And honestly, I couldn't even figure it out until I kind of took a look at the instructions and saw the picture. Like, oh, okay, so this thing moves. So this guy will come like this. You'll have the little button on the end. You have the pliers in the front. Now, how do you open these stupid things? Well, you give them a squeeze, and this guy will snap. Now, this takes a decent amount of hand strength to do, so don't think you're going to break this guy. And when you give him a squeeze, you can see that latch there will undo itself from here. And this part also moves as well. And when you are ready to start a thing or a spinning project, you just push this guy down. And you can see from how my knuckles and my fingers turning collars there how much effort I am putting into that guy. And then you just slide this back and it goes and holds itself down. And from here, he just opens up all nice and neat. Pretty simple. You put your wires in the end. You go to close him back up, slide this back so it catches, and there you have your wires hanging out the end. Now, as far as this part goes, it's very hard to demonstrate at the moment, but once my husband gets here and we can show you how that part works. Basically, you have something holding onto your wire at the other end, so way over here, depending on how much wire you want to spin. You have somebody or something holding your wire, and if you decide to do a something as opposed to a someone, make sure that your wire isn't around something that if it cuts into it, it's not going to mar up your furniture or anything. So think about that. But the point is to grab a hold of this guy, and he will cause this to spin as you pull him, and then you let go, you hold on to this guy, and when you let go of this, it keeps everything all nice and spun up this way, but this is all right. So it's just pulling, this will twist and spin, and then when you're done, you grab a hold of it, this guy will snap back this way. So that's it in theory. Will it work? We're going to find out. I'm going to even show you guys me trying to make this thing work first go around. Wish me luck. I'm going to need it. Okay, so we have some 26 gauge wire. And for everybody out there that doesn't know, this is my husband. Say hi.
Hi.
And he's helping me with this because I can't quite figure out how to do this by myself without getting my furniture involved. And I really don't want to mark up my furniture with this heavy thing. So this is 26 gauge wire. I've already labeled it. And we're going to go ahead and put him in the pincers and put him in nice and straight. My husband is holding a pin in his hand, but I've already taken all the guts out of that. So if that ends up breaking, I don't have to worry about ink going all over the place. So if you do decide to try this out for yourselves, keep that in mind that if that breaks, I won't have ink everywhere or marker bits or anything else. So you might want to empty the thing. So I've got this thing front loaded, and I am going to assume that they're going to want me to load it nice and straight in there. I'm going to squeeze it nice and tight and go ahead and latch him. There we go. I'll hold on to him nice and tight, babe. And the point is that you pull, grab a hold, let go of the back. Yeah. Pull, nice spin, let go, pull, spin. Oh. And that's what we've been having the biggest issue with when it comes to this 26 gauge wire since I tried to do an earlier video on this. And I thought it was going to be easy. And you can see none of it's even spun. 26 and I dare say anything thinner than a 26 is probably never going to work with this guy. But fear not, hang out till the end of the video and we might yet see if we can't come up with a couple of alternatives. Or at least experiment with an alternative. So, this guy, whoop, final thing there, this is 20 gauge. For some reason I don't have any 22 around the house at the moment. Apparently I need to order some more. But regardless, go ahead and put him in there nice and straight. And yeah. Close this down, slide back, latched on, and spin, spin, spin. Pretty quick. How tight we can get this guy here. And to let you all know, all the children are all sitting around us in a semicircle, very fascinated at the moment. Keep holding. Yeah. Just making sure you're ready, honey. Okay, now I'm starting to feel this get really, really stiff, and I'm feeling a lot of resistance. So I'm going to assume that he's very close to done here. And obviously, because you're seeing this video and I'm using a pretty large gauge wire, we are going to be ready to make your own spun wire because we're going to do a few more videos on it, probably bracelet related. This is going to make a humongous base wire. Yep, and I think he's done. So the ends ended off breaking off in the jaws. I'm not too terribly surprised with that, and I dropped it.
I work hard and do this.
Yeah, with, like my husband said, with how work hard in this gets, and again, in order to use this wire, once you are done spinning it, you are probably going to have to fire it up. And yeah, let me see if I can't get the camera to focus on this here. If I take my husband out of the equation, maybe it will. Well, I'll show you at the end. This is a very, very nice tight wire, and I'm pretty satisfied with that. So, let's move on to another gauge. We can at least assume that with this tool, 20 gauge is quite satisfactory. Now this guy, oops, yeah, this is 18 gauge. So, into the slot. I'm sure this pin is not going to survive all this. Make it nice and straight. I don't want any loose areas in this because if this ends up being longer and there's more on this side, it'll probably end up spinning pretty funny. Yep, my fault, not this thing's. And squeeze down. Yeah. Now, I haven't pre-done any of this, so you guys are pretty much finding out right when I'm finding out about all this. Squeeze the ever-loving hell out of it. All right. So I had ended up putting this too far back in, and you know what? I don't think we're going to be able to do the 16-gauge. We'll try, but... And begin the spin. Are you feeling any difference as far as the gauge wire and how hard you have to hold on to it?
No. Okay. I was just wondering if the little thing would pop off.
It's not the most... Probably a dowel rod would be far better. I don't have a dowel rod around here, so... Use what I got available to me. For wire weaving, having your own set of dowel rods available is probably an extremely good idea because you can get all kinds of nice curves that way of different sizes. Especially the larger sizes when your hopper or your looper and your round nose probably aren't cutting it anymore. I feel like I'm just about to drag you along, honey. And I think we're done. Same thing happened as before, just the end that's all nipped inside of that broke. And we have ourselves another nice spun wire. Again, I'll show you the details as soon as we are done here. Now, we're going to try the 16-gauge copper. All of this is copper wire. Do you think you want to use the barrel of it rather than that? Going to be the biggest base wire you ever saw. Okay. Just lashed it in. Snapping. All right. Oh, no. One thing snapped. Both ends didn't snap.
Yeah.
Okay.
One did.
Well, that's intriguing. All right. So we don't have nearly as spun a piece, so probably at this point, heating it up to making it softer, this is dead soft wire bought from any craft store, so... Probably not necessary. It's probably still going to need a little bit of heating involved. And, well, that's all the gauges I think my hand can take. I do have 18-gauge wire around, but oh my god, what am I going to make with that after I spin it? The spinning wire practically doubles its thickness. I'm kind of show you that. I do have a gauge plate here. And when you use a gauge plate, the actual, if I can see mine, there it is. This one in particular, the middle number is the actual gauge. There are three sets of numbers. And you are looking for the wire to slide through these open slots here. You want it to be not easy, but also will fit with just a little bit of effort. So this guy won't fit in there. Okay, we just took this 16-gauge wire and turned it into 12-gauge wire. Yeah, I'm not going to make bigger wire. Forget that. You guys can do it at home on your own. And from there, this guy, this was the middle wire that we ended up spinning. He spun much tighter, so he must have ended up being something in between, because he's not a 12, but he just won't fit in that 14, and I don't want to mark it up. But it shouldn't. If you have to mark it up to try to get the fit, then you're trying too hard to make it fit. So it's probably somewhere a mythical in between. If all of you ladies out there, and I know I have quite a few ladies, but for you gentlemen that actually watch me, just know... Women's pant sizes are not the same as men's pant sizes. It goes from 14 to 16. You guys, it's waist times leg length. For us, it jumps in size. So when you go, when your girlfriend or your wife goes from a 14 to a 16, it sounds way worse. Because it is. Damn it. Because you skip a size and it just mentally, it just ends up being wrong in your head. Well, wire's kind of the same way, except it skips two sizes. Let's try this 20 here. When he doesn't fit in the 18, he doesn't want to fit in the 16, but he is, I can feel him wiggle in that 14. So he's probably somewhere in between there, the mythical 15, I guess. So keep that in mind when you are spinning a wire. And now we're going to try my other idea as far as getting this 26 gauge wire spun. Okay, so yes, power tools. Yay. So we're going to try to spin this 26 gauge wire with this Dremel. Please do use safety glasses. I can't make you wear these glasses when you're messing around with your stuff, but at least please do when you're using electronical powered things. So we're going to see how well this guy does spinning our wire. Babe, sitting in the shop. Now, the thing is that I like about this idea is that power tools have a setting. The more you pull the trigger, the faster it goes or the slower it goes. So you have a lot of control that way. Don't just push your thumb down and then just let it go. And then, because as you saw, if it breaks, then you got a wire that's spinning so much, breaking, and now it can go any direction whatsoever. You know what? I'm gonna do something. I'm gonna cheat. Maybe. We'll see. It's probably stupid of me to not think of it first. But like I said, in this little review, you are seeing everything unfold exactly how it is. This is just regular masking tape, putting it around there nice and tight, so that way this thing has something larger to grab a hold of, and then that will in turn put more pressure on the wires because he's putting pressure on that tape, which allows it to hold it. Oop. Again, if you spin it the correct direction, things will go much, much better. All right, attempt number two. I can't believe it's still spinning. Gorgeous. I can't wait to show you guys. Oh, that's beautiful. I wonder. Ah, back at it. I wonder. Okay, I'm a little disappointed. My husband is running the camera for me and he didn't finish that little statement. I left it wide open for him too. He continues to ignore me.
What?
I said I wonder, and you didn't finish it.
What's in Wonder Ball?
There we go. Alright, I'm going to see what happens. My pin's probably going to break, so what's going to happen? But let's go ahead and nip this off. I haven't heated these. You can see they're still the same color. Again, spin correct direction. And this is 16 gauge wire. Attempt number 2. First one with power drill. Look at what broke. Nothing broke. Oh, how about that? Now that is a much more beautiful spin. And what was happening, I thought that maybe the wire had snapped somewhere and that's why it wasn't spinning anymore. Apparently, with at least this power drill, which is, what are you? A portable cordless, apparently.
Porter cable.
Oh, here we are, Porter cable. Dyslexia, it's fun, right, when you're trying to read fast. Apparently inside of this, because of this getting so tight, apparently there is a point where it's just not going to hold on to it anymore, and that's kind of a safety feature if you want to think about it. So that got a whole lot tighter without breaking anything, which probably maybe this guy would also do, but you still have to put it in there and keep spinning him. That was suggestive, I apologize. But you still are going to need a second person. Now, let's see here. This guy here, which would be the 18. On yet. I stopped myself that time. Alright, first attempt with the power drill. And that got considerably tighter as well. Alright, well, that got nice. And now for the 20. And here we go. Now, that part broke. Now, either that could have broke because of all the work hardening from this guy here, or it could be because it got too tight. But since none of the other ones did, and especially the very teeny tiny 26 gauge didn't even break there at the loop, and I did like a really, really awful job putting those two back together. So, I mean, you can see it's not gorgeous by any means and could very easily slip. I'm going to actually end up blaming this breaking on this guy. So I'm going to go ahead, grab a hold of that, nice and tight. Well, I think that wire's done. And he was one of the ones that did turn out quite beautiful by the time this guy was done with it. So I'm going to go ahead and say that this guy worked hard in this wire so much that it's just ceasing to really want to do anything until I fire it up with actual fire. Okay, now you can see the results that we got here of our different wires. The 26, which is this top one, 20 here, 18 here, 16 here. These all started off at a foot apiece. Now, this one we're going to have to kind of disregard because it did snap when we started using the spinner pliers, wire spinner pliers. He did snap, so I did have to do a little bit of finagling so that way I didn't end up just wasting the wire. And we got some gorgeous spins going on. And I will do some close-ups for you guys. But this guy, the wire spinner. Honestly, I think I've wasted my money. But hopefully I can keep you guys from wasting yours. He's not super duper expensive. But honestly, putting the money towards a nice power drill. Or even just a hokum one. Doesn't have to be super expensive. Honestly, would probably take care of your needs much, much better than this guy. This is what I call a gimmick tool. It's really only good for one thing, and the idea behind it's pretty nice. But you need two people in order to be able to use it relatively safely, I feel. And even if you do somehow get a chair rigged up, for as much force as I had to put into this guy and making him spin, I would probably have to put my foot out against the thing, lean back, and then try to spin it to try to keep the chair from just getting pulled towards me. And you can see my husband trying to resist me quite a bit. He's a wiry guy. He may be slim, but he's got some strength in him. So this is a gimmick tool. It's nice that it has wire cutters in it. Maybe I can use it to cut wire around the house, but honestly, this is a big waste of money, a big waste of time, because you're going to have to get a second person involved. This guy, along with a pair of safety glasses, I'd still recommend, because of the multiple settings that are available for this kind of a power tool. And you can see this guy's battery powered. He's not a plug-in one. He's fairly easy to walk around with and do what you need to get done. I do recommend you find one in pink, you ladies out there, or paint one pink, so that way your husband won't steal it. It can stay in your workshop. My father was the biggest offender of, oh yeah, you know, my daughter's in real estate. She has a measuring tape around. I'm just going to get in her bag and sneak off with it. Well, I got a pink one, and it was a shiny pink one. Dad never stole that one. I'm not real estate anymore, but I do not have to worry about either my husband or my dad stealing my measuring tape. So probably paint it pink so that way you can get your husbands to leave it alone. And for you men out there, have fun trying to find it wherever it is you left it. I know how you fellows are. Overall, we got a lot more spin out of the power tool than we did the wire twister. Whoop, camera's dying on me there. Then we got out of this wire twister. The other big problem with the wire twister, you saw how much it was moving, how much effort went into it. More or less, all that movement ended up becoming a big issue because, as we can see with this wire, he broke here, he broke at the end where there should be a loop that we were using. He just basically work hardened this guy in so many places without firing any of these. None of these were fired at any point in time. They were just taken off the spool all the same. And they were all taken off the spool at the same time, so they all have all been work hardened to the same amount. There is no differences between these wires when I did this. This guy just work hardens everything so much. Even if you did unclamp him, put something in it, and then kept trying to spin it, it's just going to keep work hardening and work hardening it. And there again, yeah, you can combat that. You can combat it with having a little flame around and going ahead and softening up the wire and then going ahead and spinning it. But there again, power drill. Didn't have to do that. Did it with one person. Honestly, don't waste your money. I wasted my money for you guys because I love you. Have a wonderful day, and thanks for coming and hanging out.